Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti G6-PTZ. This is a dual lens camera. It's available in black and white. We're just going to be looking at the white model today. Now this is not a big technical overview. I just want to show you all the components that you get in the box and how it actually all fits together. So let's jump right in and see what we've got. So heading off to start with, you are going to have your get started guide. You may not actually do anything with that. What else have we got then? So from then, you're going to get quite a few screws and lugs, as you can see here. You're going to get a small tool for doing up the screws that lock everything in place. You're going to get a quick release tool, which I'll show you about those as we go on through. You will get a drilling guide. This is for the back plate, which I'll show you in a moment. And you are going to get your pole mount. You can see on here the ridges that we've got on this side here that allow you to go through the pole, and as a result with that you also then get your metal zip tie that, as you can see, will actually lock through there and allow you to lock it to the pole. You'll then bring your main mechanism up to it, or your main portion of your device up to it, and actually screw that through there, and then the camera will hang below that there. So you've got your pole mount option if you're wanting to pole mount it. You are going to get a couple more drilling guide. Well, you're going to get a guide to just show you how all of this fits together. And you're going to get another guide because you can actually ceiling mount this, which is slightly different to some of the other Ubiquiti PTZs. So again, I'll show you how that works together. You're going to get this portion here. This is actually for ceiling mounting this. Or if we use it up this way, you can actually use this as a freestanding option. So again, I'll show you how that fits together in a moment. You have got your ceiling mount bracket for a hard surface. You are going to have here a couple of bungs to allow you to, this is an IP66 rated once you've put all the water seals in this, so we'll work outside in all weather environments. The bungs, one is for this unit and the other one here is for this one. A lot of pieces with this. You are going to get basically a rubber stand. This goes in to this if you're going to use this as a desktop stand. Okay. Hopefully I'll be able to show you that in a moment. You're going to get the main lock. This is the same as you would get with the G5 PTZ. And this is the piece that actually locks onto the camera itself. The bung will go in here, and then we'll put the casing on the top. So we'll put these together to show you the different ways that these fit together in a moment. Then you're obviously going to get the camera itself, which is what everybody is really looking for. As you can see here, we've got two lenses. We actually have a speaker in this device as well. We've got one telephoto and we've got one wide angle. We've got infrared detection here, probably up to about 30 meters, according to the spec sheets. Obviously, you've got a built-in microphone. Let's just rotate it around here. Over here, you take this off. We can put an SD card in here for edge recording. Some of that is enabled and some of it is coming soon. The idea that if it can't talk to your OS console or UNVR, that it can actually store some of that footage on here and then transfer it up later. As you can see, we've got a good 90 degree travel that way, and then the ball will actually move all the way round this way. You can see that's probably to about 270 degrees is my guess. Let's just have a look how much further. And we've got probably almost to 330 degrees. We've got most of the way. It's only just locking at that point, which is almost all of the way round. So that's actually the portion of the camera itself. Then we've obviously got the stem looking down into this. So you can see we've got our reset hole in here, our Ethernet. Very interesting, under here we actually do have, let me just see if I can just take the cover off here. We do have a USB-C connector. So I'm assuming that we've got some other accessories coming to work with this in due course. Like I said, small reset in there. Network card's 100 meg. We don't need anything really much faster than that based on Footage that we're bringing out from this. Now, do remember this is a PoE Plus device. This uses, I think, 24.5 watts of power, so it's pretty heavy usage. So do make sure you plug that into the right port to make it work. So how does this all fit together? Well, the simplest option that we've got really here is our normal wall hanger. So our wall hanger will actually clip on the top like this in place. As you can see, this is now ready for us to mount directly onto the wall, or like we talked about before, you can obviously put in your pole mount at that point in time. You do get a bung to go with this, so obviously you're going to pass your Ethernet cable through this, and then this is actually going to push down in place. I think I've got this the right way around. Let's just have a little look. Have I got this the right way around? There we go, that's the right way around. You can see that that's going to push down neatly and hold that in place. So obviously our Ethernet cable has gone down and through there into place. And then obviously your cable will then come out from that point. And you've got an egress option, so you can come out directly through here. Obviously you could come straight down the back of this if you wanted to. You can see there's a slight cutout there, or come back straight through the wall. Once that's in place, you've got a small locking pin here, one of those screws that I showed you with using the driver that's in there. You can just lock this in place to stop this being able to move this way. And we've got the same here. Then we're obviously going to then put on our top, our waterproof plate like this as well, and be able to lock that in place. And then our camera there is fully hanging in that position. Bring it up to the camera here. You can see that's how it's probably going to be for most people in that configuration. You do have like a home starting option here, so you can tell this where you would like it to always be facing every time it powers on. Right, so then let's carry on. We do have another of other options, and that's based around this piece here. Let me just pop the camera down there safely. So this is multifunctional. So a little bit interesting, it will come out of the box actually with this rubber pack already put in place. Let me just see if I can just put this back in the way that needs to go. The idea being of this, that if for some reason you have a surface that you want to mount this on just as a freestanding, then we can do it as this. You can see there's a small little plate that we can remove here that will allow us to bring the Ethernet cable directly out of that spot. And then we could obviously mount this just literally on the desk like this. So we just follow our same process here, which is to lock this into place. Let me just see which way around it is. There we go. You have to basically put your hands inside, twist it into place. You'll be able to lock again with the pin that's in there, and out this comes. And then obviously like this, we can sit this directly on the desk. And now it would work in this scenario. You might have a scenario that works for that. Otherwise, again, we're going to do it without this piece on it. So now we've got the option to go if I want complete hard surface ceiling mount. I don't think you'd probably be able to mount it like this, because I think you would lose quite a lot of ability. I've not tried it that way round. I think it's just designed to hang this way round. So again, we have another plastic bung. So we've got our options here. If this is just going to be hard surface mounted and this is going to be inside, then we have our ceiling mount plate here. Very similar to all of the wireless access points. So obviously that's going to be screwed up onto the roof like that. We're going to then be able to basically offer this up to the this plate itself. If I can do this right, let me just have a little look if I've got this the right way around. No, I've not got this the right way around. There we go. Gonna have it around that way there into place, and then obviously what we can do is we can rotate it. This would be, so this would be mounted in place, you'd rotate it to lock it into place. Obviously you'd have to have everything connected together. Your egress of your Ethernet cable is going to be out there, or it can come straight up through the middle if you've got a hole there. And obviously that's now locked in place. You can use the quick release tool here. You can see the small hole. You push this through in this location here, which would pop this lever up and allow that to come out, and you'd be able to then untwist this to bring it down off the ceiling. Alternatively, again, you're going to mount this outside. using the same process, I would suggest you use the plastic bung that they provide with this to actually get it all into place as you want it to. Again, you can see it is fairly well sort of formed to give you the ability to push a pre-made cable. You generally can probably with a bit of force get one with an RJ45 on the end of it already through the end of that. And then basically you can push this down into place. If I can see if I can get this the right way round. Allowing for your Ethernet cable to still come out. There we go. So that's going to push down into place and seal that into place. You've still got your option here for your Ethernet cable to come this way. And then obviously you're going to put your locking plate in there and clamp it up onto the ceiling. So quite a lot of bits and pieces that make that up, but hopefully that's been useful to actually have a look at that. It's a really, really nice camera. Be aware of the amount of wattage that you've got running through that. Make sure it's got PoE plus, like I said, almost 25 watts. You've got those two lenses on there that's going to give you double shots. One is wide and it's got a 10 times hybrid zoom. So a combination between optical and digital as well. So hopefully that's been useful. Why don't you head on over to our YouTube channel? We've got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, wireless and camera security. So why don't you subscribe and stay up to date?